شريك لك لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك.
بوأنا لإبراهيم مكان البيت ألا تشرك بي شيئا وطهر بيتي للطائفين والقائمين والركع السجود وأذن في الناس بالحج يأتوك رجالا وعلى كل ضامر وعلى كل ضامر يأتين من كل فج عميق.
All praise is due to Allah, Lord of the worlds, and blessings and peace be upon our Prophet and upon his followers and companions. The honored Kaaba is called the Ancient House. It is the focus of Muslim hearts in every corner of the globe. Toward it are directed their faces and hearts. Humbly reverent in prayer to Allah alone, five times a day. Muslims have traveled to the ancient house from every part of the earth to perform their religious rites and perform tawaf around the Kaaba since the time it was built by Prophet Ibrahim, peace be upon him, to be the first house for the worship of Allah, where Allah would be worshipped according to guidance and true vision with a pure belief free from superstition and erroneous concepts. Allah, the Exalted, said,
إِنَّ أَوَّلَ بَيْتٍ وُضِعَ لِلنَّاسِ لَلَّذِي بِبَكَّةَ مُبَارَكًا وَهُدًى لِلْعَالَمِينَ فِيهِ آيَاتٌ بَيِّنَاتٌ مَقَامُ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَمَنْ دَخَلَهُ كَانَ آمِنًا وَلِلَّهِ عَلَى النَّاسِ حِجُّ الْبَيْتِ مَنِ اسْتَطَاعَ إِلَيْهِ سَبِيلًا وَمَنْ كَفَرَ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَنِيٌّ عَنِ الْعَالَمِينَ.
It has been confirmed from the Prophet, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, in hadiths of Al-Bukhari and Muslim, that Islam is built upon five. Testimony, that there is no God but Allah, and that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. Establishment of prayer, giving zakat, fasting Ramadan, Hajj, pilgrimage to the sacred house of Allah. Thus, it is clear to us that Hajj is among the pillars of Islam and that whenever a person has the ability, his Islam is not complete until he performs Hajj. However, Hajj is not required except once in a lifetime. After Allah had made Hajj an obligation, a man asked the Prophet, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, is it every year, O Messenger of Allah? He, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, replied, Hajj is once, and for one who does more, it is voluntary. Narrated by Ahmed, Abu Dawood, and An-Nisa'i. The Hajj must be purely for Allah alone and not for showing off or gaining a reputation. Allah the Exalted said in a Hadith Qudsi, I am the most self-sufficient of partners, needing no partnership. If one does a deed for me and for another simultaneously, I abandon him and his partnership. Narrated by Muslim and Ibn Majah. In addition, the Hajj should be performed according to the way taught by Allah's Messenger, peace be upon him. Therefore, we advise our brothers and sisters who intend to perform Hajj not to travel until they have learned how the Prophet, peace be upon him, did it, so they can comply with the order of Allah's Messenger. Take from me your devotional rites. Narrated by Muslim.
الحج أشهر معلومات فمن فرض فيهن الحج فلا رفث ولا فسوق ولا جدال في الحج وما تفعلوا من خير يعلمه الله وتزودوا فإن خير الزاد التقوى واتقون يا أولي الألباب.
Types of Hajj Rites. Those intending Hajj choose one of three kinds. 1. Tamattu', Umrah followed by Hajj separately, which requires the sacrifice of an animal. 2. Qiran, Umrah followed by Hajj, which requires the sacrifice of an animal. 3. Ifrad, Hajj alone, which does not require the sacrifice of an animal. At-tamattu', one assumes ihram for Umrah during the Hajj months, which are Shawwal, Dhul-Qa'dah, and the first 10 nights of Dhul-Hijjah, saying Labayk for Umrah with release until Hajj. After completing the tawaf and sa'i of Umrah and cutting the hair, he or she is released from ihram and all its restrictions. Then on the 8th of Dhul-Hijjah, he assumes ihram again for Hajj from his place of residence and sets out to complete the Hajj rites. He is required to offer a sacrifice of a sheep or goat, or 7 people may share in the sacrifice of a camel or cow. If he cannot do so, then he must fast 3 days during Hajj and 7 days when he returns home. Qiran. The pilgrim intends one ihram for both Umrah and Hajj, saying Labayk for Umrah and Hajj. Upon reaching Mecca, he performs Tawaf al-Qudum and Sa'i, which serves as the Sa'i for both Umrah and Hajj. He does not cut his or her hair and remains in ihram until the 8th of Dhul-Hijjah, when the Hajj rites begin. Then he completes the Hajj, except that he need not perform Sa'i a second time. He also is required to sacrifice a sheep or goat or share in a camel or cow as one of 7. Ifrad. One intends ihram for Hajj only, saying Labayk for Hajj. In Mecca, he performs Tawaf al-Qudum and Sa'i for Hajj, remaining in ihram until the rites are completed. He is not required to sacrifice an animal since he did not perform both Umrah and Hajj. Before ihram, it is recommended to do the following. 1. Wash the entire body when it can be done easily, but there is no blame if one does not bathe. The aforementioned is from the Sunnah and applies to both men and women. 2. Trim the nails and mustache. Remove underarm and pubic hair. 3. The man removes all of his regular stitched clothing and puts on the ihram garments. The woman removes her fitted face mask or niqab. She can cover her face from non-mahram men by letting down a part of her head cover, khimar, over it, and there is no problem if the cloth touches her face. After bathing, the man perfumes his body, but not his ihram garments. Upon completion of that mentioned above, the pilgrim makes the intention to complete the Hajj or Umrah, and by doing so, he or she has entered the state of ihram. If one intends ihram immediately after an obligatory prayer, it is good. Or he can pray 2 rak'ahs as the sunnah after wudu. If one is performing Hajj or Umrah on behalf of someone else, he makes that intention at the time of ihram and may say, Labayk for so and so. Labayk, Allahumma labayk. Labayk la sharika laka labayk. In alhamd wa ni'mata laka wal mulk la sharika lak. I respond in obedience.